What they did was they took a line from Turner and Hooch, which was a movie I'd made for Disney, and they actually did have a small piece of computer animation, which was Woody saying the line.
Oh, no, 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 you're eating the car! Don't eat the car! Not the car!
Oh, you stupid dog!
I saw Woody, and he talked like I did, so it all made perfect sense.
It's on my box. Ages 3 and up. I'm not supposed to be babysitting Princess Drool. Hey, look! I'm Picasso!
Sarge, you seen Slinky?
Sir! No, sir!
All right, thank you. At ease. Good.
What if Andi gets another dinosaur? A mean one? I just don't think I can take that kind of rejection.
Well, no, no, listen, no one's getting replaced. This is Andi we're talking about. It doesn't matter how much we're played with. What matters is we're here for Andi when he needs us. That's what we're made for, right?
So this is when you hold up your eyes, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we're just like,
I can't see a thing.
Yeah.
All right, gangway. Oh, I wish I could run faster. Why do they wax these floors?
Buzz Lightyear to Star Command. Come in, Star Command.
Why don't they answer?
Don't let it get to you, Woody.
I know Andy's excited about Buzz, but you know he'll always have a special place for you.
Wait a minute. You don't think I meant to knock Buzz out the window, do you, Potato Head?
Buzz Lightyear mission log. The local sheriff and I seem to be at a huge refueling station of some sort.
You!
According to my Nava computer.
Shut up! Just shut up, you idiot!
Sheriff, this is no time to panic.
No, this is the perfect time to panic. I'm lost, Andi is gone, or they're gonna move from the house in 2 days, and it's all your fault!
My fault? If you hadn't pushed me out of the window in the first place.
Oh, yeah? Well, if you hadn't shown up in your stupid little cardboard spaceship, taking away everything that was important to me.
You talk about importance. Because of you, the security of the entire universe is in jeopardy.
What? What are you talking about?
Right now, poised at the edge of the galaxy. Emperor Zurg has been secretly building a weapon with a destructive capacity to annihilate an entire planet! I alone have the information that reveals this weapon's only weakness. And you, my friend, are responsible for delaying my rendezvous with Star Command.
You are a toy! You aren't a real Buzz Lightyear! You're an action figure!
You are a child's plaything!
You are a sad, strange little man.
Where was the last place you left him?
Right here in the van.
Well, you're just not looking hard enough.
My, what a lovely hat, Mrs. Nesbitt. It's very becoming. More cream? Sugar? One lump or two.
I knew you'd come back, Woody.
Save it for the jury. I hope Sid pulls your voice box out, you creep.
Buzz Lightyear! Any other toy would give up his moving parts just to be you. You got wings. You glow in the dark. Your helmet does that whoosh thing.
Come on, Sheriff. There's a kid over in that house who needs us. Now let's get you out of this thing.
No. Go. Just go. I'll catch up.
I was actually acting in there a little bit. There's a whole bunch of... You hated it, though.
It's got to be a less painful way to get my attention.
Merry Christmas, Sheriff.
Gee, I better shave.
I've enjoyed it because I've always loved animated films, and I've always wondered how the voices get done, and now that I know how they're done, I will never, ever do one of these again.
Don't worry, in just a few hours, you'll be sitting around a campfire with Andi making delicious hot schmoes.
They're called s'mores, Buzz.
Oh, my little sweet potato!
Oh, you found it! Oh, it's so nice to have a big, strong spud around the house.
He pulls away and he reveals this little squeezed toy penguin. And he says, Wheezy, is that you?
Hey, Woody.
What are you doing up here? I thought Mom took you to get your squeaker fixed months ago.
Nah, she just told him that to calm him down and then put me up here on the shelf.
Well, why didn't you yell for help?
Well, I tried squeaking, but I'm still broken. No one could hear me. Besides, the dust aggravates my condition. He kind of falls over.
Woody catches him and he says,
what's the point in prolonging the inevitable? We're all just one stitch away from here to there.
Sweet mother of Abraham Lincoln!
Turn me around, Bullseye, so I can see.
Hey, slow down!
Help prop up Vegetable Man or we're done for.
Well, get ready. For pork chop.
I got a pack. Let's see. Wallet, keys, tickets, passport, a beef jerky. You gotta bring beef jerky. Very expensive.
Say, little missy, you notice any
trouble around these parts?
Oh, wait. I got it. Oh, this is great. Okay. All right. The bandits got the critters tied up in the burning barn. And now for the best part.
I can't go. I can't abandon these guys. They need me to get into this museum. And without me, they'll go back into storage, maybe forever.
Woody, you're not a collector's item. You're a child's plaything. You are a toy!
For how much longer? One more rip, and Andy's done with me. And what do I do then, Buzz, huh? You tell me!
Hold it! There's a couple more bags coming from the terminal.
You're gonna see it's a destiny.
The only character that we had to recast, unfortunately, was Slinky Dog, because Jim Varney passed away right after we made Toy Story 2. But we've recast him with a really talented actor named Blake Clark, who very much captures the essence and spirit of Slinky Dog's character.
Yeah, we ain't ever getting played with.
I try to picture in my mind Jim when I was doing the voice and try to, you know, talk like Jim.
We are gathered, Woody.
Okay, first off, we all knew Operation Playtime was a long shot.
Yeah, more like a misfire.
But we've always said, this job isn't about getting played with.
You're going into the attic mode, folks. Keep your accessories with you at all times. Spare parts, batteries, anything you need for an orderly transition.
And the race car track.
The race car track, thank you.
And the old TV.
There you go, the old TV. Hey, and those guys from the Christmas decoration box. They're fun, right?
Well,
and someday, if we're lucky, Andi may have kids of his own.
And he'll play with us then, right?
We'll always be there for him.
Come on, guys. Let's get our parts together, get ready, and go out on a high note.
Where'd you leave it this time?
Someplace dark and dusty.
Can I have your computer?
No.
Your video games?
Forget it, Molly.
Why do you still have these toys?
Molly, out of my room.
3 more days, then it's mine.
Andi threw us out!
Yay! Ha! Fellas! I know what to do! We should have done this years ago!
What, Jessie, wait. What about Woody?
He's fine, Buzz. Andy's taking him to college. We need to go.
Buzz?
Woody!
What's going on? Don't you know this box is being donated?
It's under control, Woody. We have a plan.
We're going to daycare!
Daycare? What, have you all lost your marbles? We can get back to Andy's, but we gotta move fast. We'll hide under the seats till we get back home.
Well, hello there. I thought I heard new voices. Welcome to Sunnyside, folks. I'm Lotso Huggin-Bear. But please, call me Lotso. First thing you got to know about me is I'm a hugger.
And he smells like strawberries.
This is where I live. Ken's dream house. It has a disco, it's got a dune buggy, and a whole room just for trying on clothes.
Oh, you have everything!
Everything except someone to share it with.
Where are you going?
That's my Broadway stage run.
Barbie, come with me. Live in my dream house. I know it's crazy, I know we've just met, aw heck. But when I look at you, I feel like we were made for each other.
I have a kid. You have a kid. Andi. And if he wants us at college or in the attic, well, our job is to be there for him. Now, I'm going home. Anyone who wants to join me is welcome. Come on, Buzz. Buzz?
Our mission with Andy's complete, Woody.
What?
And what's important now is we stay together.
We wouldn't even be together if it weren't for Andi. Look under your boot, Buzz. You too, Jessie. Whose name is written there?
Bluebells, cockle shells.
At last, I'm gonna get played with!
Rex?
Come to Papa.
Well, excuse me. I'm trying to stay in character.
Hello, I'm Trixie.
There is no way out. Just kidding. Door's right over there.
I'm not a girl's toy.
I'm not. Why do you guys keep saying that?
That. There it is. It was filed under Lightyear.
We're on a cowboy. Trixie?
Oh, that's just a velociraptor toy down the street. That's nothing. Let me take care of that.
Oh, Woody, oh, missed you, pal.
Oh, you look good. Hey, you lose some weight.
You're not a toy. You're an accessory. You're a purse with legs. And
get complicated. Where's Potato Head?
And this is Buzz Lightyear. The coolest toy ever made. Look, look, they mean a lot to me.
Hey, you kids, stay out of my butt.